Have you ever come across a girl who isn't completely mesmerized with bling? Well, I haven't. From my 10-year-old cousins to even my mom's aunts, women love bling. And tonight, we're celebrating Swarovski's love affair with India and India's love affair with bling. Hi, I'm Pallavi Batra. And we are at Swarovski's Sparkling Inspirations 2014, where they are celebrating a decade in India and their role as an integral part of the Indian fashion industry.
Hosted recently at the Austrian Ambassador's residence in New Delhi, Swarovski Sparkling Installations 2014 was a gala evening attended by friends and contributors of brand Swarovski.
We have with us Mr. Vivek Ramabhadran, the MD of Swarovski Elements India. Good evening, sir. Are you enjoying this evening?
Oh, very much. I hope you are enjoying this evening. Fantastic.
So, sir, we've just seen this really remarkable fashion showcase, which is very unusual. So, tell us a bit about the concept behind that.
Just stepping back, I mean, the concept for the whole evening, it's the evening is called Sparkling Inspirations. Right. We wanted to just get a lot of our customers in, our designers whom we've been working with, and a lot of the other brands we've been working with, showcase some of the products as you see here. And the idea is that we ride on our customers getting creative ideas to use our products, and we believe our job is to actually help them get the right ideas and then, you know, help them realize that. So that's what this whole evening is about. What we saw out there was basically a tribute to our designers who've been with us, you know, since the beginning. You know, and very thankful to them. They've really helped us bring what was really an unknown brand 12 years ago and give it a name, give it an awareness in a very local, relevant context. And it's all about special occasions. So the bridal wear, the couture, which you saw, so it's a very nice fit with Swarovski. We're extremely optimistic about the future. As you've seen, we have Marcus Langer Swarovski, we have our management team. They've come here to spend a few days. We're really trying to understand the market. We believe, as Marcus himself said, India is one of the top three growth markets for us over the next 5 years. We believe that India requires a different approach to actually realize that potential, and we're in the process of actually doing that.
So in fact, I just read somewhere that Swarovski has sort of been accepted as a made in Austria, apna brand in India. So how's the journey been for these 12 years, and what are the plans for the next 12 years?
Oh, it's a great question. I mean, I think as far as journey is concerned, it took some time initially to figure out where we wanted to be placed, who we wanted to be associated with. Because we are not just another ingredient, you know, in the fashion space. You know, we need to be true to what our brand really stands for. But it's been, you know, I would say initially a fairly slow and steady pace. But after that, once we started understanding the market, it's been fantastic. It's been a memorable journey so far. In terms of, I think we're very well placed now. I mean, I'm glad to hear that you say it's an apna brand as well. No, it's very heartening to hear. We work with people who want to make beautiful products. And our endeavor is to actually help them do that through the sparkle which we can bring, through the quality which we can bring, and through the glamour association which we can bring.
So we saw a lot of installations here of Swarovski being used in things other than clothes. We have handles, we have clocks, we have umbrellas. Yeah. And a very interesting thing that I saw is that you've also started dealing with South Indian textiles. I just read that you've done Swarovski elements on Kanjivarams and Pochampalli. So what is the idea behind that, bringing a modern touch to traditional design?
No, absolutely. First of all, in India, I mean, we have to understand that it's all very regional specific, right? So even the couture, the bridal which you saw, that's very much focused on the North Indian side. Now, the same bridal segment in Chennai or in Kerala is very different. So that requires us to basically work with sari brands. You'll find here Chennai Silks, Kalyan Silks. These are brands which we've actually started working with more closely. We've focused a lot last year on developing customized Indian motifs with our products, but traditional, right? So in a Kanjivaram sari, you see the paisley, you see the peacock, you see the mango. So working on that with innovative different products, and you know, that's a fantastic opportunity which we see going forward. Essentially, we're about elegance, we're about sparkle, and our vision is to bring that.
The parting question then, Vivek, where in your personal life or your home have you used Swarovski the best?
Oh, that's a fantastic question. My wife's jewelry.
The evening saw a rare exhibition of stunning pieces by international and Indian designers and brands from the worlds of couture, fashion, accessories and interiors. All the pieces on display had one thing in common: the glamour and elegance of Swarovski crystals. The variety of items on display underlined the versatility of the Swarovski crystals.
We we have with us one of the biggest names in the Indian fashion industry, JJ Valaya. So you've had a really long association with Swarovski ever since they started in 2001.
Yes.
How's the association been for you?
Well, really long is an understatement because I was their first brand ambassador. Right. So it actually began when they came into India.
Yeah.
And it's been a fabulous association, and I've actually very effectively found, I believe in a very royal signature in my clothes. And like the gems and the jewels of the past, this is the modern day answer to that. And I'm more than happy to kind of be associated with the brand.
In fact, you were one of the pioneers in introducing Swarovski elements in Indian couture. So how hard was it for you back then?
Actually, it was very exciting because it was a lacuna I was facing. And whilst we have fabulous embroideries and all, but we really don't have anything close to this medium to enrich or to sort of complete the picture. So when they came in, and I was fortunate enough to be their first brand ambassador, I discovered this whole new world.
Right.
So for me, really, it was a lot of fun, and fun enough for me not to let it go till now.
Yeah,
so,
it opened up a realm of possibilities.
Absolutely.
Now, one of the emerging trends that we're seeing is that we're moving away from Swarovski in clothes, and now there are opportunities to do Swarovski in interiors and home household items. In fact, one of the installations I saw, teapots and clocks made out of Swarovski.
Yeah.
So how do you think our viewers can use that? Would you like to give them some tips?
Well, I think this is exactly why I said it's a versatile medium, because you end up using it anywhere and wherever you really feel like. It's all about balance also. I mean, an overt use can sometimes not look fantastic, but balancing it with the right kind of, in the right kind of environment and with the right mediums, in that lies the secret. So it's all about balance.
The very cool, the very fashionable designer duo, Shiva Naresh, my personal favorite. Hi guys, how are you enjoying the evening?
Hi, very good, thank you. I'm enjoying it very much.
So what do you guys think about this amazing fashion show that we had tonight?
I think it was brilliant. It was concise, it was precise, and it's a very good way of presenting a smaller collection, but yet they had varied designers and it was brilliantly presented, yeah.
So how long has your association with Swarovski been?
We're going to finish 4 years in March with Swarovski. It's been a fantastic collaboration, fantastic partnership. And yeah, we look forward to many more years ahead now.
So what is the coolest thing that I find about your designs is that you have brought in Swarovski elements in a way that no one has done in India before. Everybody's been using it in Indian bridal wear, but you have brought Swarovski into beachwear. How did that happen?
Oh, I think a lot of women out there who want to honeymoon, and I think when you're on your honeymoon, you want to look your best. It's just every woman's dream to look glamorous on their honeymoon, I think. Of course, everyone shouts for Truso, but I think there's a lot more that you look forward to post the wedding, and that's where we come in.
Right. So how has it been? Has it been accepted very well in the Indian markets?
Very well. I mean, give them Swarovski and they love it.
That's a really great way to bring in the fun element, because you guys are the younger lot of designers and you can strike a chord with the younger generation who's really, really fashion friendly.
Well, we're doing our best.
So modest. Now, just last questions. Where in your life have you used Swarovski? In your personal lives or in your own homes?
Own homes? On my cushion covers, yeah.
Lovely. So go ahead, enjoy the evening. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Good night. Crystal and Swarovski. These words should give you an idea of just how exclusive this evening is. The who's who of the fashion industry have descended right here at the Austrian Embassy in New Delhi. Now, we have been promised a very sparkling evening with a very unusual fashion show. Or as they say, a fashion showcase rather. Can't wait to catch it.
Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, I just wanted to wish you a very, very warm welcome to the Austrian residence. It's a great joy and privilege for me to welcome Swarovski here tonight. It's not only because Swarovski is doing great things, but because I think that Swarovski epitomizes what Austria, in my view, stands for. which is perfection, technological innovation, design, and in all modesty, beauty. Marcus, may I invite you to say a few words?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And now I have to take my piece of paper because I practiced some Hindi for... I don't know if it still sounds good, but I practiced on the way from the hotel to the embassy, which was 1.5 hours, so it really should be good. Namaste. This is good already. Aap sapika hardik. It's to the heart, no? Hardik. Abhimandi hai. Somewhere. Very, very warm welcome. I'm really, really happy to be here in the Austrian embassy on Austrian ground tonight. It's my second time to India. The last time I was here was 14 years ago in the year 2000, where I was I had a very, very particular role. I was judge of the Miss India contest together with Shah Rukh Khan and Carolina Herrera. And no one knew me at that time, probably still don't today. But I chose a very, at that time, Priyanka Chopra won. So I can say I was a part of shaping Indian culture already, being part of it at least. I wanted to take the opportunity because I don't know if many of you know Swarovski in depth. One might say Swarovski is just glitter and bling, but it's much more than that. Swarovski was found by my great-grandfather in 1895. He really had this idea of creating something which is beautiful at the same time accessible. So a very, very modern approach to luxury, because I think Swarovski managed over the time to have a proprietary and own definition of luxury, which is basically a form of inclusive luxury, which even does not exclude elites. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you, Marcus. Marcus hasn't been here for 14 years. I almost thought we had to organize another Miss India to actually get him here. I'm so happy that was not the case. A lot of you would have seen the products which have been displayed, and I'd just like to point out that it's a wonderful encapsulation of the diversity we have in this country. We've got products from all over, different parts of the country. We have wedding couture, chandeliers, wall panels, saris, even umbrellas, actually. You know, but there's one unifying theme which actually unites us all, and that is our collective endeavor to make beautiful products. A product which, when somebody looks, makes you smile, makes you marvel at its elegance and style and sparkle. Your sparkling inspirations keep us going. Thank you so much for your support along the way. Have a lovely evening, and let's look forward to writing the future together. Thank you very much.
Designed fashion show was one of the highlights of the evening. With hot couture made with Swarovski crystals from international designers such as Vivienne Westwood, Ferragamo, Valentino and Giorgio Armani was on display. Equally shining amidst all that dazzle were exquisite pieces by Indian designers such as J.J. Valaya, Tarun Tahiliani, Sunit Verma, Manish Malhotra and Gaurav Gupta.
Icons of the Indian fashion industry, Rohit Bal. How are you enjoying the party, Rohit?
It's wonderful, thanks.
Yeah? So, you have had a really long association with Swarovski, right? How's it been for you?
Sparkling.
We've seen the inculcation of Swarovski elements not only in women's wear, but a lot in men's wear as well.
True.
So how else do you think that can move forward? How can fashion incorporate Swarovski now for men as well?
Swarovski as a product and as a brand transcends all gender. Right. It's not about women or men. I think it's just about glamour. I think it's really about state of mind. It's about an attitude. I think anyone and everyone who has even the slightest sense of adventure will have Swarovski involved in their life. You understand what I'm trying to say?
If they have a blingy attitude,
will always
they'll
be
wear bling.
Absolutely. And why not?
So Swarovski is really big on the international scenario as well.
Yes.
Do you see a difference in how Swarovski is accepted in India and in how it is accepted internationally?
The concept of glint and glimmer and shine and radiance has been a part of Indian culture. And whether it was, diamonds and rubies and emeralds, right now I think most people, all of us, we can't really afford the diamonds and the emeralds. So we feel that Swarovski is as beautiful and as glamorous. And so all of us, we're fans. What do I say? We're fans. We love Swarovski.
Thanks for chatting with us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And then there was more. Everyday extraordinary jewelry, garments, shoes and accessories were also on display. There's lots more bling and shine on the other side. Stay tuned.
Kind Pallavi, thank you.
Thanks. I want to talk to you about how Swarovski is so big in the global scenario and how you have had a really long association.
Yes,
with
I'm very fortunate, very lucky if I may say so myself. I've had a association with them almost 10 years now, and since I signed up with Judith Lieber in America, it's been 4 years since I did that, and my contract's been renewed now for another 3 years, and I do all the collection for Judith Lieber in America, and we use all the incredible innovations with Swarovski, the Galactic Stone, you know, all the beautiful new innovation to do. And I actually head to Barton's in Austria.
Right.
So they're very kind to invite me each season, and I go, I work on the trend forecast and I look at the new collections and I do the bags. And this year at the Golden Globe, we had Jennifer Lawrence carrying the Sunit Varma for Judith Lieber bag done with Swarovski. I think the season before at the Met Ball, we had Jennifer Lopez. Then we had Mariah Carey carrying the bag at her world tour. So, as you know, I feel very fortunate. It's a brilliant association for me, yes.
Swarovski is really moving away from just clothes. There's a million options here, like we saw in the action. You have clocks, you have handles. So why
umbrellas.
Why don't you give some tips for our viewers on how they can incorporate Swarovski in their daily lives without overdoing it?
Well, I think Swarovski has a certain elegance that needs to be minimal.
Correct.
It needs to be minimal, so whether it's a beautiful bindi or it's a henna, you know, with some Swarovski incorporated or piece of jewelry or on your clothing or on your wedding invitations, I think it sort of goes a very long way. You know, Swarovski goes a very long way, and its incorporation in design is very multifaceted.
Yeah.
So it doesn't have to stop at clothing at all.
It's a parting question, Sunit. What is the coolest or wackiest way that you have used Swarovski on your person?
I don't think you want to know. And I'm not going to tell you.
So on that note, we'll let you go back to your party and we'll leave that to the viewer's imagination.
Watch out for Pallavi.
Thank you. I've managed minutes with the biggest fashion icon, Tarun Tahiliani. How are you enjoying the party?
It's a pleasure to be here. I'm having a lovely time. I thought I might not come because I was not feeling well, but I walked in, and when I saw Julia Langer Swarovski dressed in one of our Sire Dreams, I mean, how amazing does she look? Really? Well, it's always nice to be here. I've been associated with Swarovski for over 20 years.
Wow.
I go visit their Wharton's, you know, design center.
Right.
Even tonight, what we are showing was designed over there, you know, certain techniques. So it's nice. I mean, you know, you support each other. And I'm Cindy, I like Swarovski.
Now, speaking of jewelry, you know, for Indian weddings, jewelry has always been gold or diamond. Do you think it's possible it's moving towards Swarovski now?
You know, at another time, say 60, 70, 80 years back, Chanel was the first designer in France. I mean, she was a pathbreaker in so many things she did. And she started mixing real jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
She did a lot of beautiful collections with Verdura and other big leading jewelers with her costume jewelry. Her pearls are made out of Swarovski, you know. And I've always done that. And when I read about it, I said, wow. Because what is the matter? It's about what it's look.
Yeah,
you're not
exactly
wearing a bank balance.
Exactly.
I mean, that's a really tacky approach to life, right? Wear things that are beautiful, that feel beautiful, that are beautifully made.
Absolutely.
That's what's important.
Where would you put Swarovski in your own personal wardrobe or in your house?
Where would I use Swarovski? I would use it in a beautiful frame. I have my beautiful, you know, my jewel cushions that are, you know, Swarovski with their dull colors and their new colors, all their opals. I'm doing a perfume bottle, so I'm looking at putting, you know, a Swarovski bottle. So there are projects like that. It's appropriate that one element of shine, like you have this one thing on your neck, you know, that's the way to use it.
So I think that's something every girl will be waiting for. Thanks so much for chatting with us.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Have
Good
a lovely
you.
Evening.
Thank you.
Bye.
You too.
Swarovski evening with not only the biggest names in the Indian fashion industry but also designs by the biggest international designers. Armani, Valentino, Jean-Paul Gaultier, Vivienne Westwood. The party is now just getting hotter, so this is me, Pallavi Batra, signing out as I go join the fun. Good night.